Blackstone presents Bloody Martini, a Felonious Monk mystery by William Kotzwinkle. This book is read by Chris Henry Coffey. Bloody Martini. 2 1/2 ounces vodka. 2 tablespoons tomato juice. 1 dash lime juice. Add tomato juice, vodka, lime juice, and 2 cups ice cubes to a cocktail shaker. Shake vigorously until well chilled. Pour into chilled cocktail glass. And never turn your back to the door. 1. The Mexican sun was fierce. My robe and straw sombrero cast a shadow that looked like a malevolent entity of the desert with pointed head and wide, floppy wings. Given my violent past, it seemed a good likeness. Only 2 young girls were sharing the mountain with me, and they were steering clear of my shadow. I caught sight of them now and then as they tugged at the roots of a plant, bending their slender bodies to the task, their thin arms strong. The wax of the plant would bring their mother money enough for flour and rice and a handful of beans. They didn't know that through my abbot, I sent money to their mother and to the other mothers of the village, so they might buy something for themselves, a dress, a mirror, some new sandals. The local drug lord did the same, so both God and the devil were working the same street. I shook out a plant, relieving it of little stones and weeds, then put it into my sack. Through the exhausting heat, I could feel the power of that hillside, which housed rattlesnakes and lizards whose bite is like hot lava in the veins. A Gila monster can smell an egg buried 6 inches under desert sand, and I knew they were around me, feeling my footsteps in their bellies. It was an atmosphere that tuned the spirit. Venomous reptiles give you a picture of the world as it really is, and you are a fool not to know that. The young girls on this hillside held that picture in their mind. They might be children, but they weren't fools. They knew that men and poisonous reptiles had something in common, and that confrontation was always a mistake. They stayed away from me as they stayed away from all men. You can sell a bag of cocaine only once, but you can sell a girl many times a day. Whenever I glanced their way, I could see they were ready to make a run for it. What a childhood. And what would they be as young women? I couldn't see their future. As for my own, monasteries around the world are the refuge of hunted men. So far as I knew, no one was hunting me at the moment. I'd inherited a significant amount of money, and money can draw an impenetrable veil over one's actions. It had been drawn over mine, so I picked my plants, plants that gave wax for candles, healed scar tissue, and were used by local villagers to treat venereal disease. Undoubtedly, it had other uses, for everything that grew around here had its secret chemistry, in league with the sun and the rocky soil, and therefore magically inclined. I was a monk in the Sonoran Desert because I enjoyed having that faint, dry scent of mystery around me, and there was as much of it here as within the dark walls of the monastery. And then the girls were running away, having sensed a vibration in the ground that I'd missed. But I felt it now, the approach of tires that were causing a rumble in the earth. I watched an expensive pickup truck nose into view, Ford in big block letters across the nose, glamorous running lamps on, aluminum running boards gleaming in the sunlight. It was a brand new Raptor with some nice aggressive tires that made it a real rock crawler. Above the windshield was a rack of spotlights that gave it the look of a giant spider hunting for prey. Because I'd worked in my father's auto repair shop as a kid, I was a Benedictine with cars in my bloodstream and could appreciate the blue accent package on the body, as well as the sound of its high-output twin-turbo engine. But even with all this road romance in front of me, I was only momentarily distracted. The truck was out of its natural habitat. Hunting in these hills was poor, unless, of course, you were hunting little girls. Then I remembered that the government had decided to help the Candelia pickers, which meant that some university-trained team of scientists would interfere with centuries-old techniques that worked. Maybe this truck was...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.